everybody. For those of you tuning in after the fact, we are in a backyard in New Hampshire right now. Welcome to our Friday night gap. Was Alex on the drums right there? So you watch it. these people in his backyard. So we got here, so this has kind of been an interesting afternoon. We were here early and folks kind of showed up early, so we've been playing for a little while. These folks in the yard have been watching Alex do crazy things all evening so far. Just like that.
Go Alex!
Very graceful. That should be muted right now when it's blinking on and off. Are you losing sound?
They're complaining.
What's that?
They're complaining.
Not lost, but quiet.
Gatherers, are you complaining out there?
Yep.
It's funny, we spent a long time this afternoon trying to figure out and make sure that this sound was going to be okay, so hopefully. By the way, Riley, come in front of the camera and say hi to everybody. She's been, oh, look at her. Oh, she hates it. Dress is undone, like Jericho's song. Sunrise is shining, day is a dime, and it's only just begun. I hear
yeah.
human beings hanging out with us. Woo! Not only that, here's the coolest thing. Not only are there real human beings hanging out with us right now, but they have all managed in an incredible team-like fashion to stay social distanced. And it is amazing. This yard is set up in big pods. And people are stationed. They were assigned pods when they walk. Oh, nice, Riley. Aww, look at that. Ian, as soon as our hosts, they own a gym, so you can see the CrossFit cones delineating the pods. They may or may not make everybody do push-ups when we're finished.
Very social distance.
Yeah. No. Not tonight.
Thank you.
Riley, are you sure that microphone is not faced in the wrong direction? You're not sure? Because I'm pretty sure it's backwards right now.
They're saying they can hear a lot of people.
Yeah. Us, yeah.
I wonder.
They can hear us.
I'm going to say, I just got it's much better from my daughter.
They can hear
watching
us,
and texting.
I keep getting,
isn't this the little, see this thing right here?
No,
the behind the scenes of live broadcasting. Yes. You get it.
No, 5 second delay.
It's all live.
Let's, you know what? Sounds a little bad.
Yeah.
How about we unplug this microphone and see if it just works with the phone? We're going to try some stuff, gatherers. All right?
Bobbing and weaving, man.
Okay, so now, no, let's try it without.
This is your charger. Yes.
Oh, you're right. Okay. We'll see. I hope you can hear okay. Okay, we're going to try it this way. All right.
You know what I'm going to do?
It may be. This is very, there is like virtual drama happening, and actually gatherers watching, the gatherers here in person are watching you and your rage out there on their phones while they're here live.
The flash is on?
I love it.
Flippy Adam. It's funny because, like, you know, there is a goal whenever we get on a stage, even a normal stage, to make this time that we spend together as raw and honest as possible, right? But the goal, actually, I mean, when you are on a stage, we want to put on a good show for people that buy tickets and come out, you know. The goal shifts slightly at the gatherings, for me at least, which is, you know, not only to be raw and honest, but to also challenge ourselves in unexpected ways each night at the risk of train wrecking. But that the gathering can be, for me, a metaphor for life and the unplanned and messiness of it all that we all know about. Right? Anyways, this is an old school song, so we're gonna see if we still have it. Remember how to.
Am I in a wrong key? I don't know. I think in a probably.
They're getting pretty good at knowing what's coming.
Is that the right key?
Yeah.
You could do that too. Time. When the pressure comes tightening. not played this song in a while. But some of y'all might know it. Even if you are seeing us for the very first time, and even if you don't know anything about our music. Man. There are not too many songs. Just I hear a song and I just feel like, okay, everything's gonna be okay. That song does. Riley, there was a light that was going on, like it looked like there was a light on the phone that was on, and then it mysteriously went off halfway through that simple. We didn't lose the feed or anything, huh?
Nope.
All was well.
Oh, looks good.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, nice.
Woo!
Well, gatherers out there, I don't know if you know this, but, you know, right behind the camera is Supergirl. She's here, actually. And, no, they didn't.
Yes, they did.
Come on. Riley says you detected her voice.
And they saw her when you did the panoramic.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that's right. Supergirl, you are allowed to sing along with this, okay? So. but anyways, this was Supergirl's request. She wanted to hear a song of ours called The Mountain.
Oh, good choice. Her other dog's favorite.
Thank you.
I just don't want to get kicked out of the gap.
Thank you. Were you hoping for that one?
I was. I so was.
Basement.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
All right. I didn't hear who said it, but we can do it. So we're going to do that. Now we got... We have stuff to accomplish, people. We also have Ian's request, too. I'm sorry, this is Supergirl's fault. She made me play a song that I had to retune my guitar for. Wait a second, was this at one of the hotels? I was there when Alex was trying to fix an air conditioner? Oh my god.
It was amazing. Alex was fixing things in general is awesome.
Good save. Not the one I think of. We had a request for a song called the Basement Song. Yes. A lot of you gatherers out there, and maybe you all that are here tonight, have heard me talk about this song once or twice, probably. For years, over a decade, in fact, I lived in a very, very nasty, nasty basement in Somerville, Massachusetts, which is only about an hour from where we are right now. Is that about right? Hour 15?
Yeah. Hour 5, hour 10.
Yeah. Alex says an hour 9.
Exactly. Dialed in.
Done it in 45 minutes.
Say that again?
Who's the engineer?
You have done it in 45 minutes? Everybody stay away from that gal in the corner.
She has
dangerous.
To.
He's a dangerous person. Oh, who asked that?
Somebody asked you?
Who's the engineer?
The engineer tonight? That's a good guy, because I have I not talked about her yet? Well, so gatherers watching. Oh, yeah, we did. We did introduce her, I think. But our engineer tonight, for those of you that don't know, is Riley, and she's working her little tail off. Of our family, and she's pretty fun to roll with. Okay. Anyways, this is a song inspired by the basement, called the Basement Song. Let me know. It's cold down in the basement. Town rides, start another day with Peter Pan, surprise. Well, we are tight on time. Fuck it. All right, sure. These poor gatherers have suffered so much so far. You broke a string in the middle of a set for opening the Blues Traveler?
Yes, I did. And my case with my spare set of strings was all the way like up a flight of stairs that we weren't supposed to really use because it was like for Blues Traveler, like we had this, we were supposed to use like the service entrance. And I went like careening around the corner and up the stairs and like grabbed a string and I finished it.
I always wondered why they didn't invite us to open for them ever again. And it's either because you broke a string or I talked too much. That was a really fun day. I didn't know you broke a string. There was one time when she broke her bow and like had to duct tape the end of like the bow, it looked like this big
always prepared
thing.
Always prepared.
Yeah.
Okay.
Threw off all the balance, it was wild.
I find myself lost. For the first time. Thank you. I know I'm a shithead. I know it's me that took off and left. But I was just anxious and dumb. Thank you. stick around, because as soon as we finish, we're going to finish. We're just going to sing a couple songs together before. For those of you watching out there, thank you so much for hanging with us. And if you haven't met them before, I want to introduce you to my incredible bandies that are sharing the stage. On the bass, Ponce, Ponce. Ponce, as of today, is releasing a new single. Let me see if I got it right. Canta Senda Verde.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow, not today.
It's like the Red Sox, but different.
Oh, special day tomorrow. Okay, got you. For those of you that don't know, Ponce is from Bolivia, where he and his family help run a wildlife sanctuary. They rescue hundreds and hundreds of animals down there. It's an amazing place. It's called Senda Verde. And those of you out there, you have heard Butcher and I both talk about this a bunch at this point. But he has been. Some of you maybe here don't know this, and maybe some of you gatherers watching don't know this. But Butcher is releasing an album one track at a time each week, and the newest track is a tribute to Senda Verde, and it's being released tomorrow. Butcher, where can they find that? Where can they find information about you and your music?
Easiest way is Facebook, Ponce, P-O-C-H-E. You just find me there, and then you'll have all the links to Senda Verde. Senda Verde translation is the green path, so you can find it sendaverde.org, O-R-G, and yeah, that'll be the best way. Thank you.
Nice. On the drums, Alex Martin. On the fiddle, Karina Smith. I want to thank our friends at Well Told for supporting what we do. I want to thank Riley, our sound engineer, for helping out with the group tonight. I want to thank our friends and volunteers from Rally Sound. I want to thank our friends at Well Told. Did I already do that?
No.
Oh, good. Right on. For you well-tolders out there, there's a bunch. I see a bunch of well-told mugs around here. That'd be awesome. Thank you all so much for being here. Tomorrow night we are going to be playing a completely different set, except for the very last song, from a backyard in Connecticut. So the adventure will continue tomorrow. Please stay safe. Keep on looking out for one another. And we will see you tomorrow.